at 6:30 and we have a complete board.
4:30.
Man, we got through the hour in a hurry. Let's do a pledge of allegiance, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay. Okay. I guess I just got done seeing that as far as the pool. It is all cleaned out. It's pumped down. We've got a little bit right in the bottom of the basket to clean out, but that's going to probably just sit there until we decide what we're going to do, because it's going to be there next time we use it. Either way, it's over the window and it leaves and garbage in there.
And snow.
So anyway, it is in sufficient condition to be looked at, to evaluate, and I'm kind of aiming for a December meeting of this entire community and find out what kind of support is actually going to be happening. We'll present what the estimates are, we'll see what the dollars are, we'll find out the actual interest of the community. Are you willing to step up and help? And then we can make a decision from there on that. I have a list of the pool inspection, which there's nothing terrible that I see. There's some things that'll have to be fixed, but I think our December meeting is gonna be before this makes any difference at all.
So I have a question about, you brought this up last year that you were going to have some pool companies come in and look at our pool and give us some ideas. But my question now is, why haven't any of them been here yet? Because this was a year ago that we started talking about this.
I can't answer that yet. I know Jim had talked to him. I didn't talk to him. So I'm not sure where that fell down, but I'm the only one doing it this year, so I know for sure what I can do. And we've got to decide, because there's enough stuff that needs to be fixed before
sure.
we can reopen. So yeah, that's a legitimate.
But we definitely need to get something done. I mean, even this fall, the weather gets bad.
I think now's the time to do it, because most of the pools are going to be closing, so I imagine the pool companies are going to be out beating the bushes to find bid jobs for the next year.
Okay, so do you have the names of those 2 to 3 pool companies already? Or?
I have given them to Jim, so I've got the one that I gave him, and he had one, and I'll get his back or find out where he's at. I was kind of hoping he was going to be.
He should be coming. This is the one that he did, because they were supposed to get pool estimates.
Okay.
And that's the one we were in contact with last year.
Okay. And the other one, let me figure out how to get out of here.
Well, we just need to expedite this process. Where we get in trouble by procrastination and delays. And
that must have been an email. I'll check that, but I've got the other one.
If you want that, you can have it.
Yeah, I'll take a picture of it and I'll have it. You'll have it.
I have one more question. At the end of this, it says, under the pool, Al asked if there has been an outcome with the kids breaking into the school. That doesn't apply to the pool.
Oh, it should be cool.
Oh, okay, cool. All right.
Sorry, that was a typo on my end.
I talked to Steve this morning, but I didn't talk to him about that, so I can't.
I think Al has nothing.
He's not, they're not gonna do nothing, but it's gonna, we're gonna have to push it from our end.
Okay.
The city is, and most are gonna recommend it's like a simple misdemeanor, because nothing was stolen.
Is that a city council deal then?
Pretty much, probably, because we're gonna go to council with it. I would assume. I mean, that mean next Monday night.
I assume that you can't do community service or something like that without litigation.
The one guy's in military, so they're probably getting him back. No, I don't know what the deal is, he'll get, I think he's in college. But I know one, he was already gone this summer to boot camp, so.
Okay.
And that we have to turn over to the military to take care of, I mean.
Okay.
And Jim kinda touched on it a little bit at the last council meeting. So it's kind of up to the city now, I think.
Anything else on the pool? It's all put away for this year, so our next step will be.
Inspection.
Me getting ahold of the two companies and getting them in here. Welcome sign, anything we need to do different there? Straight park.
I believe they got the school painted.
Okay.
On the outside for sure, I'm not sure about the inside, if they were doing that at all.
I think Jim said he still needs to work on the door. We'll still need to paint the shelter house and put some steel on that. I'm hoping to do that this fall.
And the sand still need to put underneath the cave.
Okay.
We have the sand, it just needs to be moved.
Where's the sand at?
Down at the school.
Okay. I'm gonna ask a friend of mine to use a tool to do that and to make it pretty simple. I'll go ahead and take responsibility for that. Anything else at Strike Park?
Well, since the cage put in and the swing set is put in at Sunset Ridge, I took the pictures, did the final evaluation report, and sent it into the foundation. So we should be good if the Park and Rec Boards should want to apply for the foundation grant again for anything.
Okay. Yeah, thank you very much. Anything else on Strike Park? Trailhead, anything there?
Well, we went down and we did trim the trees, but one is still looking very badly, and is looking bad. I don't know if that's the location where those trees should be placed. It must have something to do with the soil. So if that one tree, if we can get one to grow and the other tree continues to die, we're gonna have to put another one somewhere else. When we get those trees forever, because they're in the same spots that they were in last time, and they're not doing well where they've been planted.
Would fertilizer or anything do us any good?
I'm
not a horticultural, I'm just throwing it out.
I know HTP, we've continued to go down there and water them every week, according to what was stated to us. We take turns going down there. Doesn't matter, the one tree still looks really bad. So I'm not sure what we're gonna do with that. So it'd just be another question, something to check on.
Would maybe Mike Shaw down at the Gilmore Greenhouse get an opinion from him?
Well, that's where the trees came from both times.
Okay.
I'm thinking instead of purchasing more trees, if we get them through that Trees Forever, every year they ask us if we want any trees, and maybe that's the route. This way we're not paying any more money for them. I mean,
does he warranty his trees if they die in a year?
I believe they were, but that's why we replanted, but I'm not sure how many times that's going to happen. I know when I buy perennials, my perennials are warranted for 1 year. But I've never had a problem for the second year. It's just something to check on, and if I stop over there, I can ask him about the trees.
You wanna just plan on doing that?
I can do that, yeah. Well, I can also.
Tell us what.
Well, I have a.
If it's something.
I have an app that I can use that will tell me what's wrong with the tree.
What's it look at the leaf and evaluate it?
I just take a picture of the trees, the leaves, and then it'll tell me what it needs.
That's amazing. Okay, anything else on Trailhead or Wilcox? Then let's go to Ben Dixon Park. We've had games, we didn't have any last Sunday. I believe this week is the final game.
Last one, yep.
I think it's been very well attended. I think the people that are in charge of concessions should be congratulated. They're doing a great job. Anything else?
So do you think we should do a verbal, or should we give them a thank you card? How do you think that should be handled? Because we could say we're going to thank, but sometimes that doesn't happen. So should a card be sent? And whoever is in charge of that? And then?
Who is in charge of that, Jen?
Stephanie and Perry.
Okay.
That'd be perfect. You can get a card, we can sign it, and give it to Gary. I think that's the best route to go, is that just saying thank you.
So do you want to give a card?
Sure. Thank you.
And maybe when you get it, if you want to try and corral us, you know where those guys
yep,
are.
Yep, before Sunday.
And then we could just give it to them on Sunday. Mm-hmm. That would be wonderful. Anything else on Ben Dixon Park? How about Sunset Ridge? I understand the swing sets up and it looks wonderful, along with everything else out there.
You don't have to send a card.
Okay. Thank you.
No, we don't need cards. I don't think we're out to kids for a part either, but I mean the people that were here and they're not there for here. So
anyway, the park looks really nice.
Trimmed some trees down there too. I had one more I need to tend to, all this stuff coming up from the bottom. Looks shabby, so it needs to be cut off.
Quite sure how the tree dump got added into Sunset Ridge. Don't take it personal. I think that should maybe be a separate land item.
I think you brought it up during that
okay.
section.
Anyway, don't connect the two. I mean, that's not what we're trying to say.
Yeah.
Yes, it's like anything in life. When people abuse it, you lose the privilege, and all of a sudden now you don't have it. Behave, you'll have it. Then behave. Okay, Rams Event Center, I assume, is doing
nothing
differently.
No.
Yes?
HTP is no longer going to take care of the school building around the area. We have decided that we're going to remove our sign, or it might have already been removed. HTP did buy a tree and plant it down there a while back, but we would like to move it elsewhere.
Okay.
And I don't know if the whole HTP group is going to put the money in. We'll probably get Travis Shone to move it. Because if we're not going to take care of it, that tree's just going to die on its own.
Understood. Does Travis have a tree state?
I think he has a small one, and that's all we would need.
I don't think he needed a tree state.
Okay. Well, we'll figure something out, but just to make sure that would be cleared by the entire, since HTP all said yes, I'll let Parks Board to say that's okay too, because we're in charge of the school.
Would it make sense, rather than moving a tree, to get another one from this Trees Forever you brought up earlier, and just plant a new one wherever you want to put it?
But.
Or is there sentimentalism to that tree that you want to keep?
No, there's nothing sentimental with it, it's just that it's a beautiful tree, and you'd hate to leave it and let it die.
I get that.
So all I need is approval that if we choose to, HDP chooses to move that tree elsewhere, that it will be okay.
Where is that tree at?
The gym, by the gym, it's on the southeast corner, right before you go in those east doors, and then you walk down ways, and then it juts in, and there's the tree.
Okay, so it's on the south side of the building?
It's, well, southeast. So you have the gym door, the gym door.
It's on the south side, first east, southeast corner.
Yeah, southeast corner, so here are the gym doors. And you walk the sidewalk just a bit, and then you turn in, and then the building goes like this. It's kind of like not an alcove, but an L shape, and the trees right there. So would that be approved if we choose to move it?
Okay.
I'll make a motion.
Okay, we have a motion, we have a second.
Well, I second it.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded that the Parks Board will grant HDP permission to move the tree if you choose to. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
So it can be moved if you want to.
Thank you.
Will you refill the hole I opened? You'll refill the hole?
No.
Well, when you take the tree out, then you'll.
I'll knock the rest of the school building in the hole,
Just liability wise, we keep.
I understand.
Okay, bike trail.
Nothing at this time.
Okay, gazebo and heritage park. The sculptures in. You guys are going to do landscaping, right?
Well, I talked with Jan about that, and at first she wanted to put in some ornamental trees, but we decided that there are there's too much down there already. So we're not sure if in the background we're going to put some sort of perennials, or if we're just going to add a couple extra pots and maintain those. So that's something that we're going to discuss when we have another HTP meeting.
Would you guess that the pots that are out here will go back to the corner when all the renovation is done?
They'll probably go up to the golf course.
Okay. Did you want them moved that way and redo them in the spring?
Well, we'll be having an HDP meeting coming up soon, so we'll get that all discussed as well.
I was wondering, destroy the flowers that are in there right
now. Oh, please.
Yes. One person's flowers and another person's anyway.
Yeah, quite a few weeks.
Anything else for the gazebo or heritage park?
But it would be nice because if everybody who was assigned a park would help take care of those parks.
Yeah.
Even if it's going up and weed eating some weeds.
I was up there on Saturday and pulled weeds out of around the gazebo and around the statue.
Thank you.
Cut off some stuff around the tree that was growing up.
Okay.
And stuff.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
How about anything else on gazebo? Otherwise, we'll go to the community center. Where are you at with the broken windows?
I got the call this morning from Mike Meyer, who built the building. He got a hold of the company who built the windows. They have shot him an estimate on the replacement. We'd have to replace both top and bottom sashes on both windows.
Okay.
About $550, $580, something like that, not including labor. And I had also talked to the insurance adjuster who wanted costs for the windows, the siding, and the screens. So I went back to Mike and I said, would you put those costs together and then also give me a labor cost with those so that we can turn it into insurance?
Okay.
And so I'm waiting on that information.
Have they ever figured out who caused the damage?
I'm sorry, what?
Have they figured out who caused the damage?
Not as far as I know. We talked with Steve Henderson a little bit yesterday, and he was going to talk with Tyler Berenson, who was doing the investigation on this.
Okay.
And I haven't gotten any update on that.
And it's going to be sad when they start putting up more cameras all around the town. I mean, we have our place covered with cameras, and I know other people that have added cameras in the last year or two, and that's getting sad. We're, you know, I hate to say we're in rural Iowa. We shouldn't have, we know everybody. We shouldn't have to do that.
Well, the times have changed. I was just talking to the pastor outside, and he said he's had about $1,500 worth of stuff taken out of his garage. So he's had to put up security cameras there in the church.
Who's that?
Pastor.
Pastor.
Well, so that tells you where society is going.
Yeah. Well, you know, and I think it's all about parenting too, or even grandparenting. I don't know. Teaching kids morals and values and what has happened to them.
It's a different world now.
It is. It's sad.
Okay. Anything else that needs to be addressed this meeting?
Now I'm going to come up and spray the weeds that are growing up in the rocks out here, so I'll do that before the weekend.
Great, that would be wonderful. I need to do some of that.
Mary, is there anything brought up about the big pots out here?
Yes, but we're having another HTP meeting.
Okay.
I know our last one, or kind of our group meeting, we decided that we didn't want to put the pots back on the corners. What we'll probably do is just put in perennials. We'll dig it down this way. Once we get them established the first year, then we won't have to go up and replant and water every year.
Once you decide what you want to do with the pots, then we'll bring that up in the next meeting.
Yeah, something, well, I think somebody said the golf course would take them all, but, you know, if somebody else has other ideas, that would suffice, so.
All right.
Okay. Do you need to talk about the tractor, truck pull, or the bicycle pull? No?
Not yet.
Wait till we're closer. Okay. Anything else that we need to discuss today? Otherwise, I'll accept a
motion adjourned.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
And second, please. Okay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
There we go. We're wonderful. Thank you very much for coming. I think that'll work good.
The meeting goes there to 6.
6 o'clock, yes.
I'll go out and take a picture of the trees at Wilcox and find out what's wrong with them.
Okay.
I just got that app. I saved 2 of them in my yard.
Because of the app?
Well, I found out what was wrong with them. And I can take pictures of my plants, too, and find out what's wrong with them.
So,
you know,
that's what you say, what
happened? Sometimes it just needs a little sugar.
Can you take pictures of people?
You know, it's kind of funny because I have this one plant that hasn't been doing well. It says, add sugar. Or, it, yeah, there's all kinds of different things.
I know Paul Harvey used to put out really funky ideas.
And for the rest of the story.
Yeah.
Coffee grounds.